T-Weezy on the track, T-Weezy on the track. Baby boy the prince. Beat time on Cash Monroe. Extreme entertainment. Ooh,
this is the way I live. Hey guys, we're cooking up some meat right here. Yeah, we got some steak, mushrooms, onions. We're about to go sheepshead fishing in the morning all the way over in Fernandina with my boy Luke over here. We got roughneck fishing going.
Yes, sir.
So, tomorrow we're going to go pick up Tyler. Who else?
Tyler's coming here.
Okay.
And then we'll be up in Fernandina. Quick.
Yeah, so we're going over for sheepshead. We got everything we need for bait, and we'll update you guys up on that later. We got a little farm going over in the house, and we'd love to show you something like that, you know. And by the way, Connor's a character, so you'll get to meet him later as well.
T-Weezy on the track. T-Weezy on the track.
See. This was the master with my own little twist. He always told me you got to do a little 6-inch leader. So what I decided to do is every time you go out sheepshead fishing, you got to pre-tie your leaders. We got at least 10 tied here, maybe more, and all at different lengths. You see, we got some longer, some shorter, some in the middle. And this is all to test what the fish are biting on. And the important thing is also, as you know, fishing with sheepshead, what you're going to do is you're going to run into a lot of pylons and a lot of structure. So when that happens, you're breaking off a lot.
Yeah.
And you're going to have pre-tied leaders to deal with it. So that's our leader setup. And what we do is we take a 2000 series right here. This is a little Abu Garcia we got last year on special. Put a little 10-pound braid on here.
You want everything a little downsized because it's very sensitive.
Yes, and also the sheep's head are very finicky. So lighter the tackle, the more bite you get.
Yes, sir.
And so what we're doing here is we got the 10-pound braid. I think we got 100 yards on there, something like that, whatever. We take a uni-to-uni knot right here with 20-pound Seaworks fluorocarbon. Run it all the way down up to this swivel. Now that's about 8 feet. It's a little longer than normal. You can choose your own preference. I mean, I like 8 feet only because the weight likes to slide up and down when
so
you're
dropping
it.
So it's 8 foot to the swivel right here, right?
Yeah. Not to swivel, 8 foot. And, you know, I like that because this weight likes to slide up and down when you're dropping, especially in deep areas. And it'll sometimes get past your uni to uni and tangle everything up. So if you got an 8 foot uni to uni, you know, you're pretty set.
Yes, sir.
You're good to go. That's basically our setup. We just got off the charger here. This is our battery tender, getting everything ready for tomorrow. We got some live mud motos in here, and that's just in case the redfish come out and play.
Yeah, who knows? Who knows, right? Who knows? Gotta have the battery charger and the mud motos.
Hey, the key to a good fishing trip, let me tell you right now, is being prepared. If you're not prepared, you ain't gonna catch any fish.
Yes, sir.
Evan Williams versus Tito's.
Who's gonna catch more fish? Another thing that we like to do over here at Roughneck Fishing is we like to farm our bait. We got some fiddler crabs ready to go. It's been a little cold up here, and I don't know if you guys know, but if fiddler crabs are in the cold, they don't come out. They dig deep under, and you aren't gonna find them. / they aren't gonna be at bait shops. So we keep our own little stash here, and. Well, let's show them the little bait that we use. Where is that? I know it's somewhere around here. I just had it.
T-Weezy on the track. T-Weezy on the track.
Guys, we're back. We found the krill. Here's the bait. So, we've been feeding this frozen krill. You can buy it anywhere, really. I got some fresh shrimp we caught earlier in the year with Blue Gabe, actually. I did a shrimp in video with him, and that's what I did a lot during the summer, so we actually stacked up a lot of bait. So once this frozen krill runs out, we're gonna start throwing them some fresh shrimp. But you know, we've had them for a while. Hey, they don't like to get spooked, so be quiet. Shh. There's a little sneak peek. We done spooked him. They're already in their holes, guys. Good morning, everyone. We woke up late, of course. Yeah, alarms didn't go off. Hey, it's not too bad. I mean, it's still dark out. It's about, 5:45 in the morning. We're going to head over to Connor's. Our buddy Tyler showed up. He waited here for 20 minutes, said, screw you guys. So I don't blame him, you know. But that's how it goes when you're fishing, and hopefully we can get him out again on the water sometime. Yeah, but anyway, we got everything tied up, ready to rumble. Boat's all ready to rock and roll. So we will see you guys when we pick up Connor.
T-Weezy on the track, T-Weezy on the track.
All right, so we picked up our boy Connor on Hexer over here. Come on, he's hurting. We got him the BC Goodies powder, same here. He's getting on that fried fish for breakfast.
We got a chicken.
And we're gonna be catching some fish to fry later. One thing you gotta know about Mr. Fenwick, anytime we go inshore fishing, he brings one rod and this rod only. Doesn't bring anything else. He is versatile and quick.
That's it, baby. Come on with it.
Backing in the boat. Strokes are purring, fellas. All right, y'all, no one at the boat ramp today. All those regular avid anglers are gone. Fair weather fisherman is gone. Connor just let out a little. Connor just let out a little secret, guy. So we got some pretty rough conditions. It's like mid 40s right now. We got a 16 mile an hour wind. It's blowing pretty hard. We got an incoming tide. Waiting on it to turn around and set up and get going.
This is the way I live. Little boy still pushing big wheels. I stack my money, lay low and chill. Don't need to work hard, that's the way I feel. I feel like this is the way I live. Little boy still pushing big wheels. I stack my money, lay low and chill. Don't need to work hard, that's the way I feel. I feel like this is the way I live.
Windy and cold, but we got the target.
Not a monster, but
hey, let's get him out.
At least they're here.
Hey, we're getting on them. Got another bite, another fish. This one, Mikey. We'll see. Check out them little choppers they got on them right there. So, guys, Luke just made a great point here. We decided to fish the bridge, and you know, the tide's too high, so it wasn't really a great idea. We found this rock pile that we're fishing on over here. Started casting on it and getting bites, but couldn't feel the bites, and also were breaking off on a lot of tackle. So we re-anchored and repositioned. Now we're over on top of the rocks and able to drop vertically. And sure enough, we got some results. We got two keepers in the boat. So just a thing to think about while you're fishing, you know. If you get bites somewhere and you're not catching them, don't give up. Just go try a different method. Tide finally is a little bit cooperating with us. We got back on the pylons over here. Got our third keeper of the day, just came off. This is a beautiful Northeast Florida sheepshead right here. About a good 14, 15 incher, maybe a little bit bigger. These chompers right here, so what they do is they actually go up on these big bridge pylons and they'll come and stick their face in it and just chomp, 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 eat all the oysters, clams, anything they can get a hold of. And in those oysters, a bunch of little crabs come out. So that's why we use the fiddler crabs. It imitates the little oyster crabs coming out of the oysters as we bang against them with a shovel. We'll show you a quick little video of how we do that. So guys, as I mentioned before, Connor is the sheepshead master, and I ain't kidding. Look at this guy. I'm out here working.
Grinding.
Dude, he's grinding. He's doing the sheepshead split. We call it the sheepshead split. Let me tell you, it really does do the trick though. Doubled up, and what do you got, Connor?
Oh,
you got a nice sheepie.
Oh, what does Connor got?
Oh, first fish of the morning.
Oh, dude. That's cool.
Connor has been off the fish, ladies and gentlemen. But, yeah.
Thank you for the land job.
Yes, sir. There he is right there. You can see this.
Awesome.
This is the SeaWorks, I believe it's a size 1 short shank hook or a live bait hook. And you can see those teeth. It's so hard to hook them. I mean, look how close that is. Barely got him, but he gonna be dinner. It's different than where we normally fish, right?
Yeah, we've been fishing between the pylons, and I was checking on more on the outside of the pylons. These pylons are coming down at an angle, and I'm trying to get down to that bottom part of the pylon. It seems like I'm drifting right by, and they're picking it up.
So Luke just learned a valuable lesson and something we can teach you. Hey, dude, if you ever feel anything, when in doubt, set the hook. You know why?
How we get that shit?
Look, show it to him. No hook in the mouth there.
Where are we getting? Right out there under the pectoral.
Thing. Right in the belly, dude. That's why he was fighting so hard.
Wow, yeah.
This little sheep's head right here was just crazy. Oh, God. He went in between these two pylons and he was on the other side. I was fighting him around a corner, scraping my rod against everything, but he's in the boat. Look at him chopper. Bite's been a little sporadic today, but you know, nothing of crazy size. We're still putting him in the boat. This is number 12 now. We still got 8, 6, 8. We got what, 12 more to go that we can get? So 24 is gonna be our limit on the boat. Connor keeps missing a fish. He's gonna get it soon though.
Alright, so today it's been a very rough day for your fellow angler, but thankfully about halfway through the trip finally can put one in the box. So
after the shovel went in the water and a couple toad fish,
after I've caught about 2 toads, drop a shovel in the water, managed to put a single fish in the box, so at least I can contribute a little bit.
Funny old producer
just got one.
Yeah,
there we go. It's getting a little bigger. This is the second biggest one of the day. We got like 16, I think. 16 inches. This is about 14, maybe 15. He's getting close. Hello, folks. We got the biggest one of the day, and he really just inhaled that crab.
Wasn't much hook set on that.
Oh, no. There's no hook set. All small. Look at that one. Man. Beautiful Northeast Florida sheephead. Swallow the hook. What? About to wrap the day up here. Mr. Fenwick is really, hasn't had the best day ever, but that's okay. That's what happens when you go fishing. He actually showed us where to fish and how to fish, but sometimes you just can't put him in the boat, and that's okay. You did a great job on the net for sure. So. Solid net day. There ain't nothing wrong with that. We're out here trying for like, what, 5 more minutes, and we'll get going. I think we got like, probably like 14, 15 sheephead in the boat, maybe more, maybe less. We'll see here shortly.
Oh, that was it.
Alrighty, we're heading back now. We got about a 10-minute ride in front of us. We got soaked this morning, so hopefully we'll be good to go today.
This is the way I live. Little boy still pushing big wheels. I stack my money, lay low and chill. Don't need to work hard, that's the way I feel. I feel like this is the way I live. Little boy still pushing big wheels. I stack my money, lay low and chill. Don't need to work hard, that's the way I feel. I feel like this is the way I live.
Alright guys, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna cook these sheep's head whole here. As you see, we cut their throats here, and that's actually bleeding the fish. Luke will show you real quick how we do it. So
yeah, we bled them, soaked them in salt water, salt and ice water. It's hopefully firm up that meat. All we're gonna do is slit right down the middle, all the way down to the anal fin.
Ooh, she's tough.
There we go. Boom.
And then
a tougher one. And then we're just gonna open that up, and we're gonna gut her. Take the guts out.
Just literally pull it out just like that.
Like linguine. And look at all that white meat you could already see. Fish.
And then this is what we use to scale fish right here. You're just literally gonna use a spoon and shake it back and forth. You see the stuff come right off.
They do sell descalers, but you know what? Sometimes you can just make do.
And a spoon probably works the same.
Yeah, I mean, come on. This is coming off like cake.
All right. Here's what we got left over. This is from another fish. And we got the whole stuff. We're getting ready to cook up now. So now we're preparing the whole sheep's head like we talked earlier. Luke scaled everything, gutted all the fish. Now what we're going to do is score it. I'm sure a lot of you guys know what it is, and it really doesn't matter how you do it. Everyone can do it their own way. I just prefer about four X's on the fish. So what I'll do, make an easy slice right through the backbone, and then come across this way, same thing. And then over here, just like that. And now you got a scored fish. And the important thing is getting the seasoning all inside that meat. And we'll do that with all four fish.
All right, so we're gonna season the fish.
You know, tell them who you are, tell them who you are.
Oh, you want me to do that?
Right. Yeah, good.
Justin the seasoner.
Yeah, there you go. This is our fellow coworker. He came fishing out with us the other day. Unfortunately, we didn't catch any of these.
Nothing like this. this fish, you don't want to over-season just enough to get inside the cuts here. And we're going to show you that right now. So
this is lemon pepper right here.
Yeah.
So we started out with that lemon pepper Justin just showed you. And then just regular pepper, salt, a little bit of garlic powder. You got to be real careful with this stuff. It's super strong. So only use a little bit for sure.
So yeah, you want to get the seasoning right here and deep in the cuts right here. Kind of push it around.
By the way, guys, this is stuff that we filleted up. As you can see, I mean, when you gill these fish, it's unbelievable the difference. I mean, that is about as white as it gets. And if people really know about sheep's head, they got a pretty thick bloodline in the back. That's virtually nothing. It really does make a difference. I highly recommend it. Now what we're gonna do here, I'll get Justin the camera real quick. It's real simple. We're gonna take this fish here, lay him out, and then you wanna get some butter, which we got right here, and you gotta pre-soften it. You don't wanna melt it, just soften it. And you're literally just gonna spread it across the fish. It doesn't have to be the thickest layer, it doesn't have to be perfect. Point is to get it in the aluminum foil because it's gonna melt. That was a little much, so we'll save this for the next one. All right, and now the next most important thing is you never want your fish, when it's wrapped in aluminum foil, to have any steam coming out. You're gonna let out a lot of juice. So you wanna center it well and make sure you cover all edges. Make sure there is no room for error.
Sealed up tight.
That's right.
That's it.
And easy as that.
Perfect.
This is good.
D-Weezy on the track. D-Weezy on the track.
Yeah, dude, all right, Mr. Carter, what we got going
on?
Yeah, it's already going. Yeah, my bad. I took a couple. Well, got a great video of us throwing it on the grill here earlier, but instead we went to go check the video and I had taken two pictures.
What were they?
Instead.
Yeah. All right, guys, so we got the grill on super hot. I think it's around like 400. We got the sheep's head all mummified, as Luke was saying earlier. And this is what it looks like. We're gonna put it on the grill for about 5 to 8 minutes, all depends. And when you come back, you're gonna see some good eating, let me tell you.
Yes, sir, can't wait.
So we let these guys sit now for about, what, 3 or 4 minutes? And it's time to open them, dude. This is real deal stuff right here.
The reveal.
Unbelievable.
Yeah. Perfect, dude.
Wow.
See all the oh my goodness, the meat is so juicy. That is ridiculous, guys. Yep.
Yeah.
Good job. That sample one. We'll show you all the plates after it's all ready. What'd you think, Luke?
Bro, look at that. Just falling off the bone.
I mean, you don't see chicken tenders out there.
Oh, my goodness, man.
So, guys, the big benefit here of cooking in the fish whole, you can see these rib bones. Look at that meat. Came right off.
Man, that's good.
As you saw in those fillets earlier, we cut out all this meat right here, and you miss everything that is in between these bones. Also, if you look at this is the throat meat. A lot of people, you don't even realize.
Look at all that.
You're throwing this out every
when
time.
When you fillet this, look at, that's you're taking all that.
That is a whole beautiful piece of fish right there. Woo. Luke, tell me how it is.
I'm going to tell you right now. That tastes like a scallop.
Oh, my God.
I'm not joking. That tastes like a scallop. Yeah. That's as close to a scallop as you're going to get.
It's true.
That's off the chain.
I agree with that.
For a white meat fish, that's probably most... That's as flavorful as anything I've ever had. Mm.
So
tastes like a scallop.
So you recommend cooking it whole?
I do, absolutely. And here's the thing about the sheep's head is, if you're funny about bones, the sheep's head's bones, look, they're so thick. We're scraping this thing right off of them. You're not getting any thin bones.
Here, bang that. Look at this. Flat. You hear that?
These are thick bones. You're going to get up around them.
And then pull that meat out and see how, look.
Slides right off.
There's no.
You're not messing with small bones. You're not gonna get something in your. None of that. I'm into filleted fish. I'm into all that. But this right here, I mean, you can't beat it, man. You really can't.
Can't beat it with a stick.
Look at this, dude.
This is another method that you can do.
Just comes right off.
Just comes right off.
Yep.
And also, oh my goodness gracious, that is unbelievable. Beautiful.
Perfectly cooked, dude.
That's BA.
Yeah.
All right, so also another good reason to cook it like this is, so look, we took four fish. We're gonna have one each and have a great dinner. And what we're gonna do afterwards is, like I showed you, we had some filleted out. Now Luke's taking some of that home because he caught some of the fish. And me, myself, will obviously be having some as well. But now we can portion our fish, you know? We got this fresh stuff. We know we can eat it tonight because it was just swimming 6 hours ago, so it's as good as it gets. Now what we're going to do is portion our fish and maybe have a dinner tomorrow night and then save the rest and freeze it. You always want to freeze your fish the day you catch it. It makes a huge difference when coming back and eating it later on. So I was just doing Justin's technique there and pulling the meat off the bone. Did a really good job. And then we look. Come on. Got the SeaWorks hook right there. It sure as hell did its job because he is on our plate.
Oh my
right
god,
now.
Dude.
And guess what? I'm going to be able to use it again.
There you go. Nice.
One more sheep's head.
D-Weezy on the track. D-Weezy on the track. Baby boy the prince. Beat time on Cash Monroe. Extreme entertainment.
This is the way I live. Little boy still pushing big wheels. I stack my money, lay low and chill. Don't need to work hard, that's the way I feel. I feel like this is the way I live. Little boy still pushing big wheels. I stack my money, lay low and chill. Don't need to work hard, that's the way I feel. I feel like this is the way I live.